हेलो दोस्तों, मैं गौरव आप सबका स्वागत करता हूं मेरे YouTube चैनल कोड ऑन बायोलॉजी में। सो दीज आर द साइट्स यू कैन गेट ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट प्रोटीन। वन मोर टर्म इज देयर, BMRB मींस बायोलॉजिकल मैग्नेटिक रेजोनेंस डाटा बैंक। Now let's go for the format. Different type of websites or different type of tool accept different type of format. So there are many formats in the bioinformatics. Like we have the GeneBank flat file format, FASTA format, FASTAQ format, multi-FASTA format, GCG format, GCG MSF format, EMBL format, CLUSTAL format, SwissProt format, and SAM format. These are the example. There are many formats available in the bioinformatics tool. As example, if you get the FASTA format, there are question how to write the FASTA format. FASTA format start with this sign. As you can see here you will write the name, anything you want to write about that species or things, and after pressing the enter you will start sequence from here. That is the FASTA format. So file extension should be file.fa, file.fasta, or maybe file.fsa. So this format accepted by the FASTA tool. Now FASTAQ. FASTAQ tool accept the .FASTAQ or .SANFASTAQ or .FQ. So different type of bioinformatics tool, there are different type of format accepted by that tools. As example, if you look for the multi-FASTA format, so we know that FASTA format start with this sign. There are first line start with this sign, and you will write the information about that species or genes, and you will start sequence from here. Then for second, header should start with this sign, and then you will write the information here, and then you will start sequencing from here. You can add multi-FASTA format for further use. Next, for SAM means sequence alignment map. These tools accept only the .SAM format. So if you have .FASTA, this tool will not accept that format. You have to convert it first .SAM format. Now I have a question for you. This question is asked in DBT BET 2018. Which one of the following is a depiction of GeneBank sequence entry format? So as you can see here, it start with this sign, means this is not a GeneBank sequence entry format, this is a FASTA format. We just learned that here numeric is not visible. So this is the 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. So this is also not a GeneBank format. If you see this format, if you go to the NCBI and you will see the GeneBank format, then you will get the same format like that. First there is a name, then definition, keywords, source, organism, references, comment, feature, base count, and then origin, and then sequencing. So this is the actual GeneBank entry format. So the answer should be 4. Now we will go for the next question. Which substitution matrix should you prefer to find the distantly related ortholex through blood search? Scoring matrix is very important for the DBT JRF exam. Each and every year there are 1 to 2 questions from only Blossom and PAM scoring matrix. So how will you solve that? I'm going to give you a short trick for that. The PAM 120 and Blossom 62. This is the middle. Now we will go for the similarity. Do you know what is the Blossom 62 or Blossom 40 or 82? This means it represents the sequence having the greater than that percent identity. 40 Blossom means they have the more than 40% identity. So if we'll take it in middle, then we have two more column, like more divergent, and here we will write less divergent. You have to remember it. So for less divergent, so the PAM 1 and Blossom 80. For more divergent, it PAM 250 and Blossom 45. You have to remember these two things. If question will say about the less divergent, then you have to choose the PAM 1 or nearby this number, or Blossom 80 or nearby this number. If question will say about the more divergent, means you have to choose PAM 250 or nearby this number, or Blossom 45 or nearby this number. So in this question, in option 1 or A, having the Blossom 40 and PAM 250 means this is the nearby your answer. In next option, Blossom 82, Blossom 40 and Blossom 60, you have one more option, you can correct it as 40, but here PAM is only 120, so it will not be your answer. The answer should be A, Blossom 40 and PAM 250. If you want to check more distantly related, so you should have more PAM value and less Blossom value. And if you are checking the less distant or less divergent, then you should have less PAM value and more Blossom value. You should remember these three things. You must able to solve 1 to 2 question in DBT by this trick only. The next question is, match the item in group 1 with the appropriate description in group 2. Try. The first thing, UPGMA. What is UPGMA? Unweighted pair group method. It is a distance method of phylogenetic analysis. Means UPGMA will match with the phylogenetic analysis. Do you have any option? UPGMA 2. Or you have 3 options. Next, to go for the cluster W. Cluster W, what is cluster W? It is a multiple sequence alignment. Means it is 4. So do you have any option? This one. So you can say that your option is B. You can match another one also. SwissProt. What is SwissProt? It's a protein sequence database. And RASmol is 3D structure visualization. Now go for the next question. Which one of the following is not a structure or a structurally derived database? I think we have done that. The answer is PROSEET. Next one, the statistical significance of blast heat is obtained using. This will be the extreme value distribution. We are using this value only to calculate the significance of blast. These all are the mathematical tools. We have solved one question of Blossom matrix in 2016. Now in 2017, there are another question of Blossom matrix. The question is, Blossom matrix are based on. If you have read the Blossom, then you will know that it is based on the highly conserved region in a series of alignment for within to contain gap. It is not observed through the local or global alignment. It is not explicit evolutionary model, or it is not alignment of same sequence containing the highly mutated region. So next question is, ProDom is a comprehensive set of protein domain family automatically generated from. So what is PFAM, what is UniProt, what is SwissProt, and what is InterProt? Do you know SwissProt? We have learned that SwissProt is maintained by the SIB, Swiss Institute of Bioinformatics, have high level of annotation. What is PFARM? This is secondary sequence database maintained by the Sanger Center. It has collection of HMMS, means hidden Markov model for protein domain. So ProDom is a comprehensive set of protein domain family automatically generated from the UniProt knowledge database. So answer should be the B. The next question, this is very interesting question. You have given the proceed pattern representing the conserved sequence motif for a new family of AMP binding protein. You have, here is a given data. You are given a sequence of 15 amino acid strength starting from the first residue of motif. Which one of the following protein is likely to have AMF binding function? You have to make a motif from that formula. So how do you make that? So before solving this question, let's learn about proceed pattern notation. So proceed pattern notation uses the IUPAC one letter code. The lowercase letter x can be used as pattern element to denote any amino acid. If there is x, it means you can put here any amino acid. Next thing is square bracket. If you have these brackets, it means A or B or C, means any of them, either it will be A, B or C. If you have a middle bracket, it means any other amino acid other than ABC. If you have like that, ABC means it may be any amino acid except these three amino acid. Then N-terminal prefix with the lesser than and the C-terminal suffix with the greater than. If there is X under bracket 3, it means X, X and X. If there is X and under bracket 2 or 3, we know that under bracket, small bracket means or. If there is a number inside the small bracket, it means either X repeated 2 times or either X repeated 3 times. Here I am giving you example. You can make it CX24. Here X24 means either XX or XXXX. Here X3 means 3 times X. Here for all these amino acid or letter, if you make a profile, you have to write only one of them, either L, either I, either B, either M, either F, either Y, either W, either C. Only one letter from that. So you have time, make a profile of that and show me. You can comment also or you can write in live chat. Let's go for example. I'm giving you IQ calmodulin binding motif. This is initial, N terminal, this is C terminal. You have to make a pattern. So should I help you? If it is in a big bracket or a square bracket, you have to take only one. Either you can take the F, either you can take the I, either you can take the L, either you can take the B. Next one is Q. Q will be in all that pattern. Next, X3 time. Next, RK means either it will be the R, either it will be the K. So it will divert many patterns. So I am taking that IQ. Why I'm taking that? Because I have told you I'm giving you the IQ calmodulin binding motif. So I'm taking that IQ triple X K. So either you can take K, either you can take R. So IQ X X X R, then G, then trig X, then next R or K. So I am taking here K, then xx and then any of them. So I'm taking here I. So it is one of the pattern you can make from this one. So now we will solve these questions. So let's solve. So you can make, so you have to take any of them. Like you can take L, you can take I, you can take V, M, F, Y. So how many initial you have? L, M, L, L. Let's go for next. You will have the X. It may be anyone. X means A, B, C, D, anything. So it may be anything in second row. So you don't have to read the second row. Next means x2 time. X2 means you don't have to read also the third row. Next is STG, means it should be S or it should be T, it should be G. So in fourth row we will search for S, T or G. So do we have any? Here G we have, here T we have. So now till now we can't choose, so we will go for the next. Next STAG, so we will search in both, either here T and here also having the A. So STAG A is there also. So we till now we can't differentiate it. Now we'll go for the G. So which will have the G, that will be your answer. So here we don't have the G in any one, so we will go for the next. Here this one we have the G and we don't have here G, so your answer should be this one, second one. You can make it like that. If you know that, it's very easy. Now we will go for the next question. Gene or protein that display the same activity but have different origin and are the product of convergent evolution are called. So you have to learn about the analog, paralog, ortholog and xenologs. What is homologs and orthologs and paralogs? These all three are derived from the divergent evolution. Ortholog means member of a gene or protein family in various organism, means in different organism like human, chimpanzee. If you have the same type of protein and genes, it's called orthologs. And what is the paralogs? Member of gene family within a species. If in the same species you will have that gene family, it will be the paralogs. Let's put it all together. So you have a early globin protein and there is a gene duplication alpha chain and a beta chain. Then this alpha chain found in the frog, found in chick, found in mouse. So the same gene family are found in different type of species. It means it is a ortholog. Now there is another gene duplication, beta chain. It is also found in mouse, chick and frog. Now see, in mouse there are two type of gene, means within the same species there are two type of gene family. It is called the paralogs. So the same gene found in different type of species is orthologs. In same species there are different type of gene, is called paralogs. So in your question, this is not a paralogs or this is also not a orthologs. Actually, this is a analogs. Paralog and ortholog are the divergent evolution, means there is a common ancestor and it diverges to different paths. Talking about the convergent evolution. Convergent evolution means you have a different ancestor and it goes for the same type of character, means it's conserved. So this is the example of analogs. Just remember one thing, Paralox is the gene duplication, and ortholog is a speciation. There are many questions regarding that. They may ask on that concept, like which one is the example of gene duplication. So your answer should be the paralog. Which one is the example of speciation? Your answer should be the ortholog. Next question is from BLAST. So BLAST is a tool. You know that. So we have group 1, we have group 2. So there are T-blastin, T-blastex, blastex, blastin. So you have to learn first what is difference between the blastex and T-blastex. Blastex means we will search the nucleotide sequence against the protein database. This is the blastex. T-BLAST means translation of that nucleotide sequence against that protein database. Means actually this is protein against protein, but translation of that nucleotide, T means translation. So you have to remember these things. BLASTN means compare nucleotide sequence with nucleotide sequence. BLASTP means compare protein sequence with protein sequence. BLASTX means compare nucleotide sequence against the protein sequence, and T-BLASTN means compare the protein sequence against the 6' translation of nucleotide sequence. T stands for the translation. In the same sense, T-BLASTX means compare the 6' translation of nucleotide sequence against the 6' translation of protein sequence. Now we will go on the question. Let's match. So you will have a nucleotide sequence is to be used as a query to search for similar protein against a nucleotide database. Means it is your T-BLASTX. Nucleotide sequence is to be used as a query to search for similar protein against a nucleotide database. Means it is the translation. Now BLASTX means nucleotide sequence is to be used as a query to search against protein database. It is the normal BLASTX. This is the T-BLASTX. So your answer should be 24P and 34Q. So your answer should be A. In last year, there are questions from the scoring matrix again. So read the question. A novel protein from a deep sea archaebacterium was identified in sequence. The sequence is expected to be widely divergent from the known sequence. Which scoring matrix will produce the most appropriate alignment in search for homology in the NCBI database? So divergent means it is distant species. So we know that for distance we have 10, 250 and Blossom 45 or 40. So do we have any option here? PAM 250. We don't have Blossom 40 or 45. So answer should be B. In bioinformatics, there are very, very easy concept. If you remember that, you can easily solve more question in very less time. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you are watching on YouTube, please subscribe the channel, like the video and share to help others also. If you are watching on Facebook, like the page. If you are watching on websites, please subscribe our websites. And please don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification.